knowledge is judged, so I guess I believe in it. Damage is done, so I guess I believe in it. Oh, the damage is done, so I guess I believe in it.
Don't have to say what you did. I already know.
I found out from him. There's just no chance.
No chance.
You and me.
You and me. Don't it make you say no?
All right, good evening, everybody. Hope we're all having a great Monday night, or Tuesday, depending on where you are. We are breaking from our regularly scheduled stream schedule this week, because I have stuff going on tomorrow night that requires my attention. So we're going to stream tonight, and hope that you're having a great time. My name is Professor Yana. I'm going to be playing some Hex Standard Constructed tonight, and I don't know why some of these cards aren't loading, so I'm going to reload the client real quick. Let's make sure we only have one copy of this going on, and we'll restart. Pop out my chat so I can actually see you all. And we'll go with that. All right, cool. Let's see what we got. Should be better off now. All right. Looks like everything's loaded now. So tonight we're going to be playing a Blood Wild Deathcry deck. Just a lot of value creatures with a couple ways to abuse Deathcry abilities on all of them. Those are courtesy of Groundscreeper, which says at the end of our turn, trigger the death cries of target troop you control, and Lord Blightbark. Lord Blightbark's seen a lot of popularity recently, and he reads, to trigger death cries when a troop enters play under my control. If that card weren't unique, it would be busted beyond belief. As it is, it's very good. So we'll go ahead and get started here, folks. We're just going to play some Constructed tonight until about 10 or 10:30 my time. It's about 2 hours from now, give or take. I want to thank everybody for tuning in tonight. We got a match real quick, so let's get started. Looks like we're playing against Ivan. Move over our bunny a little bit since we're awesome. Now I want to make sure we can see that. There we go. Cool. Just waiting for our opponent to do stuff now. Deck list is on the left, folks, as you can probably see. And it will update with our reserves. Feel free to ask any questions about the deck. All right, opponent, let's get the stream started. Oh, that's our gold sleeve. Okay. Should get my cosmic sleeve for next. Assuming they show up. But yeah, good evening, everyone. Just waiting for our opponent to choose who's going first. I'm going to assume it's them. But while we're waiting, just want to remind everyone, because I just picked up all the cards for this deck, you need to pick up a couple last singles for your next text deck. Feel free to check out Battle Shopper. I have a code that you can use, YANA5, that'll get you 5% off your next order. It's good times. All right, so this hand is medium. We have, well, they're on 5, so there's a very real chance I'm just keeping this because I have removal. So we have 4 resources, 2 of which are ice, and we don't have a shin hair, so we're going to have to wait on that, but we have what we need to start. So I'm going to keep this, especially since our what is probably Redling's opponent is on 5 cards, and we have an efficient removal spell. Start with a wild ice. Actually, no, let's start with a blood ice. Now we have a shin hair, so I can play the Monzaga Lily Pad next turn. Hit a Well of Hatred. Alright. And I start with a Wicked Web Spawn. Solid turn 2 with a 7 card. I am with 5. It's great. There's our Lord Blightbark. We're going to open up with that. Let's go ahead and we'll play our Well of Ancients on Wild. We're just going to play out Blightbark. And then we can play our Blight Bush next turn to get 2 blockers. Really need to full art these things. Yep, you can have 2. Got a cremate, you got something else. Gravengeist, okay. And the cremate. Because of course you do. Alright, let's play the Alaki. Really good. This is a really good 5-card hand from our opponent. Don't have anything to scrounge with, so that's useful at least. We'll get 1 Dreadling. It's going to bash in with the Dreadling. I don't know if they're trying to force the issue with a Lasgar's Vengeance or what, but that's 3, so at 5 resources I can play it. So I gotta think about that for next turn. So let's play this. We're gonna make a Battle Hopper. And I am going to Blight Bush here into a Gruesome Deed. See if they block. That does put a troop in their bin, but I think the payoff is a little bit better for us here. In a pinch, I can sack the Blightbush down 2 Emperor's Lackey. Next turn, we just have Groundskeeper, so that's good. That'll get around Vengeance. Sure, we make some Dreadlings. Swing it out. Fine. Go to 11. Blightbark Paladin. Alright, so let's go Lily Pad here. We'll go with a Battle Hopper. And we'll Groundskeeper. I don't think I die now this turn, so I'm pretty sure I'm okay. Even if they Lasgars, I still have Groundskeeper. And I have efficient blockers. Double Lasgars probably just kills us anyway, so. Next turn, we'll just play Blightbart Paladin and start going to town. Groundskeeper is a very, very good card. Just waiting for our opponent to take an action here. Next turn, I'm also going to activate Takahiro's ability, finally. Actually, no, he can't, because I was dumb and made Battle Hoppers both times. Rust Bucket. Sure. Are we just stone dead? We might just be dead. Nope, we're not. Take five and go to six. Gonna get Lasgard. No. Okay. Naive lackey. Play Blightbark and play lackey. Alright, so use Groundskeeper's ability there to use our Blightbark Paladin trigger. Alright. Do you have two? Pad. Alright. Let's use blood here so we can gain some life back. Target troop by control with Deathcry. Yeah. Let's do that. That sounds fun. This leaves us not dead to a Lasgars. Actually, we're dead to a Lasgars. So we'll take two to draw that. For our opponent being on five cards, they've done a very good job. So, props to them. That said, we got the concession, so we'll take the win. Alright, so in this matchup, Killblade's real good. Hero falls solid. There's a lot of decent 4-ofs in that deck. Withering Gaze is great to get Lazgars out of there. Things that I can trim. Take out 7 cards. Take out the Deadeye. I feel like Combination's just a little bit too slow in this matchup. Can trim a Paul. What else do we trim here? Trim a Lackey. And I can't take out Woke. Actually, I can take out Woke. Take out Woken. Woken is not Underworld, so it doesn't hurt against our requirement. Alrighty, so we're in game number 2 here. Stand's actually pretty good. I'll start with... Actually, I'm probably just going to start with a Blood Shard, to be honest, just because I want to Withering Gaze them ASAP. Well, you can take note of their hand. Gemborn could be nice, too. Do not bring in Gemborn. There's only really one sharded or one socketed troop I care about in that matchup. Like, I could... Oh, no. They play Underworld Crusader. Should have brought it in. I should have brought it in. Period. Forgot they played Underworld Crusader for some reason. So I get to hit Gruesome Deed. They have Lackey. No access to red. So, I mean, we're taking Gruesome Deed. We have to. They have Matriarch. Good to know. The Blood Shard we know about. Yep. Unless we get a 2 drop, I think we're okay. Yeah. Not Paul Gang. Is Shin Hair, so good to know. Just play our Blood Ice for now. Yeah, Gemborn does hit 5 things. I should have played it. I hit a Ruby Shard, probably hitting Matriarch. I mean, you can. Yep, there it is. We'll take 6. Go to 12. Ford Blightbark. Alright, I think I actually am just going to play Underworld Crusader here. Just to have an efficient blocker. That way, even if they get another charge or another Ruby Shard, I can still kill the Matriarch of Flames. Ruby Ice. Alright. Smoke a ball, let's make 3. Or no, 2, because there's 2 necrotics. Fine. Hit me for a lot. 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6 after I draw. Seven because of the sack, 5 after the hit. Okay. Light Bush. That's actually very good for us. So we're going to Lily Pad to make a Battle Hopper. We will Lord Blightbark and Blight Bush. go ahead and gain some life. Excellent. Blightbark's very good, folks, if you didn't know already. Am I just going to get coined? Coin Lasgar's kill me? It might just be coin Lasgar's kill. They force me to block. Just losing another troop doing that. Oh, why didn't I block the Pyresmoke Cabalus? That's a misplay on my part. Yes, it is. We're at 2. I really should have blocked. I'm an idiot. Yep. We punted that game out. Nothing more to be said. Alright, so Gemborn comes in. I think I'm actually going to trim one under World Crusader here. Bush should have blocked just a Dreadling, I think. Sure, that's fine. No, we do not lend plat here. Please do not ask. We're gonna keep this. We have a few turns to get a relevant draw. Or irrelevant shard. Let's Withering Gaze. Gruesome Deed, Graven Geist, Rust Bucket. Well, they have it all. Alright, so again, we're going to hit Gruesome Deed. You can take out an Underworld Troop like Fentio. Okay, fair. Still a little new to the deck. Only played it one night, so we'll get there. Hey, look at that. Add this Faram. Wild now and just play out our naive lackey. Yep, we know you have it. Shocked. Next turn's gonna be an Underworld Crusader, almost certainly. There's a Lord Blightbark. Sheesh. Let me just play Fentio out here. And I believe we're also just going to sack the Naive Lackey here to draw a card. Hey, look at that hero fall. Yum, yum. That'll be nice for the incoming Underworld Crusader that we're certainly going to see. Hey, glad you like it, Plotinus. Boom, I'm shocked. You're going to get hit by a very fancy hero fall, mate. Gonna take it. Wild Ice. Sure, since we're just gonna be hero falling anyway. Gonna hero fall now. Gives him one thing that's ground with. Folks, while we're doing this here, I do want to thank everybody for tuning in. If you haven't followed the stream yet and you're new to things, feel free to give that follow button a click. It is free, and you get to know every time I get online. You want to give that next level of support, I have a new sub perk that I'm introducing starting tonight. For every subscription that I get, and this is going to be retroactive to my other subscribers, when you subscribe, you are welcome to submit a Hex deck list to me. Once a month, I'm going to go through all of those deck list submissions, and the winning submission is going to, one, get a free primal pack of the most recent set, and two, I'm going to feature their deck on stream for one of my streams per week. I'll play it for the entire time. It'll be a good time for all. So if you're interested in subbing, you can get Twitch Prime sub or $4.99 a month. Get yourself in there. You get it, you vape. We're taking a fair amount here. Give you some tarantulas. Ooh, that's hot. Alright, so let's play the Well of Ancients. We'll play it on blood. We'll play a Blight Bark and a Blight Bush. Next turn we'll play Grounds Creeper. Or we can just play Pall of Yazaken to destroy the Gravengeist or something. Or you just get Lasgarzed. Like, that could happen too. Yep. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're probably just dead. That's unfortunate. Yep. Still two blockers. Plenty to scrounge about here. Yep, every time. Sure. I'm just gonna absolutely block anyway, so. That's fine by me. Of course you did. Of course you did. I'm dead if he sees the line. Oh, can't block. Well, if he doesn't see the line. He saw the line. Oh well. Hit several relevant things there. So let's play another one. Lasgarz is a beating. I didn't see it with the Withering Gaze, so what you gonna do? Grandfather Elk, probably a ramp deck of some sort. Hit Culmination. Hit Lily Pad, have Blight Bark and Bunny. That's pretty sweet. Let's do it. We're going to play Bunny first and then Blight Bark. And it's a Bunny. We whiffed. It also makes our combination a little cheaper, so that's good. Hit three relevant things, though, which is kind of unfortunate. Like, three of our engine. Blightbark, Creeper, and Blightbush. So definitely a ramp deck. Naive Lackey. Alright. So let's board Blightbark. I'll Well of Ancients here into another Blood, and I'll play the Naive Lackey and draw a card. Then I'm going to sack the Naive Lackey to draw another card. Excellente. Yeah. Do you only have one? Why? Why do you only have one rune? Alright. I want to play in Balls to the Wall. Gruesome Deed. And I'm pretty sure I'm just going to kill that, right? Just what I do. So we go 2-1. Two, one Blood Ice? Yeah. Non-resource. Let's Blightbush. The Hierophant is missing an ear. You are correct. And it's about to miss a lot more. Let's sack one of the Blight Blossoms here. And that's missing both ears. Next turn, I'm just going to culminate them out. There's both ears. Well, culmination seems far worse. Fanteo seems great, though. I still think we just culminate them. Get a Battle Hopper. Let's, it takes three. What do they have? Communion of Wax and Blitz. Alright, so they're like trying to play like a rampy, get you quick deck, and that's not going to work too well with us, so. And we have blockers. I think we're in a pretty good spot. I'm not attacking, just makes me all the happier. That's bloody fantastic, actually. No pun intended. Alright, let's screw some deed this bad boy. You go. And we will play a Fanteo. Alright, I think I'm going to go ahead and sack a Blight Blossom here to gain some life. Draw a card. Hit a Wild Ice. Okay. We're safe to attack now. Get him in for one. Hits prompt. Here. That's pretty hot. Yeah, we're gonna do that. Yeah. And my Rooney here has 2 ears. So that's a cool thing. Alright, and our opponent concedes to not having a hand. Hooray. Alright, so against this style of matchup where they're ramping into big things, feel like Gemborn Prowler is very good. I feel like Killblade. Actually, Killblade's not that good with a Swift Strike. Hero Fall seems fine. I'll keep the two combinations. I think just the. We can play both Wokens. So to play Gemborn Prowler, we can probably take out something not as relevant. So we can take out, like, Deadeye here. And then trim on Lackeys. And Naive Lackey, rather. And one other card? What's the last cut? What do we think, chat? I'm thinking it might be like a Paul or one of the Emperor's lackeys. Probably just one of the Emperor's lackeys, right? Oh, yeah, ship me the list, Hodor. Thanks for that. I was kind of in a rush to build this deck before stream. I just picked up the rest of the cards at literally 7 o'clock, so. Should be cutting Culmination of Blood and get Lackey back in. Okay. I'll note that for game 3 if we need it. This hand's probably fine. Thank you. Paw gang. Alright. Seek some adventure out here. Shard of Savagery. Good to see the slow shards coming back into standard. Makes the mana bases a little easier on people. Grounds Creeper. Alright. So our Ruinier is going to be good and fed. Probably going to see a Ruinier of our own from our opponent here. We'll see if it has two ears, and it does. Lily pad. Alright. Let's go and play Ruinier out. Next turn we'll play the Lily pad to make our Ruinier a little stronger. And then follow up with our Underworld Crusader. Communion of Wax. Make it a Surging Wildfire that deals double damage. This is how they win. Okay. That's just 14 if I let this go through. That's Crush. That's gross. I feel like I just have to block here. Like, I think we're just dead anyway, right? Yeah, we're dead. Even if I block there. Alright, well that was a thing. Naive Lackey's in. Culmination's out. Oh, the quick game too. very quick. Oh, let's go to game 3 then. Yep, hand's great. Let's go. As I realize I actually don't have a shin hair. Awkward. Let's seek fortune. So maybe we get one. All course, we hit another blood shard. Cool. It's probably a worse keep than I thought in hindsight. I saw Blightbark and what looked like a green resource, and I just kept it. I should have looked for Shinhair before I did that. Naive lackey. Fine. Yep, that's a Shinhair. Hooray! Just like we panned up, guys. Just totally like we panned up. Blightbark and lackey. And the hero fall? God bless. I accept. And you just did it again. That's just getting hero fault. I'm gonna wait to hero fall until after they do their stuff, because I want them to activate this. Yep, there's a well. This is where I do it. You get nothing, good day. Emperor's lackey. Most excellent lackey. I'm not gonna play the lackey right now just in case they get like a gem, or rather they get like a rune here. So I'm just gonna play the Underworld Crusader right now. Burning ire. Yep, that's a thing. God bless you, deck. God bless. I don't care as much. There it is. Do you have a blitz? Yep. Is it plus four, plus two? That's gonna live regardless, so. Alright. You got me. And a grounds creeper. Cool. Now I just need something with actual death cries. Sack it so it can't hit me. I do not want to get hit for 3 damage, so it seems like the right thing to do. Another well. Okay. Let's see. Another shard. Got nothing. Another shard? Boy. Feel like I'm just sacking this. There we go. Something relevant. I'm not going to attack just in case they have a speed troop. That's literally the only reason I'm not attacking right now. Well, Ruinir. Okay. Well, that'll be strong next turn. Communion of Wax. Of course it is. Alright. It's not socketed at all. Alright, so let's start this right. So let's. Ruinir. Lily pad for a dude. And get woke. Pretty sure we're okay. Fair. And boom. Groundskeeper into Ruinir is pretty hot here. Ooh, baby. Do your worst. Your worst is conceding. Okay, I accept. Alright, this deck's pretty hot. I like it. Alright, so let's see what this update is that Hodor gave us. Give me one sec, folks. I'm just going to update this deck real quick. Thank you, Hodor, for letting me know what we got. So we're gonna update our deck a little bit here. We're down a Naive Lackey. We're down two Emperor's Lackeys. We're down to one of those for an Exarch of the Egg. Cottontailless Warblight Bush, two Wokens in the main. Okay, I guess that makes sense. Fenty Underworld Ruinir, two Blightbark Paladins. Two Paul, two Groundskeeper, one Rot. Two Combination, two Gruesome Deed. Where are my Gruesome Deeds? Yep, and then four Well of Ancients. Four Lily Pad, two Wild Ice, two Blood Ice. Seven Blood, three Wild. So there's one card in here that shouldn't be in here. What we missing? Death's Head Rider is no longer in here. Okay. It's probably fine. Reserves. Withering Gaze. Combination. Steel Intel is a 2. Noxious Glory is fine. Vampire Princess is fine. Hero Fall is fine. Gemborn Prowler is fine. One Pall of Yazakan and one Rotten Rancor. Alright. Seems something up my alley. That seems fine. Let's go with that. How's that look, chat? Any thoughts? I think that looks mucho bueno. All right, let's go with that. Let's give it a run. Do want to thank everybody for tuning in tonight. For those that are first timers to the stream, my name is Professor Yana. We play Hex here twice a week. It's normally Tuesday, Wednesday. This week I have an errand run on Tuesday evening, so I will be replacing that with today's stream. So we're streaming today and Wednesday, 7:30 to 10 to 10:30 Pacific time. And yeah, thank you for everybody tuning in. I know there's a lot you could be doing tonight, so definitely appreciate it. If you like what you're watching, you want to keep watching my content, feel free to give that follow button a click. It is free for you. Get to know every time I go online. Looks like this is going to be a burn deck with a weird champion. Yep. I don't understand why people use this champion except for the higher life total. One shard. One replace. Three shards. That's hot. Okay, I'm in. Yeah, folks, many thanks for watching. If you want to give that next level of support and subscribe, you're welcome to do that. I'm starting a new sub perk starting tonight where new subscribers can give me a Hex deck list, constructed standard of their choosing. I prefer it to be a homebrew, and I'll pick my favorite one. That person will get a free primal pack at the end of every month. And yeah, I'll be playing it on stream for one stream a week, or one stream a month, rather. Play it for the entire stream, give thoughts on it. We're going to do that starting in August, so end of August, I'll pick a winner. Sin Shadows, how you doing? Thank you for the follow. And we got a Scapa Goated. This doesn't have a Death Cry, correct? No. Alright, so let's go. I'm going to start with Exarch here, mainly because it's a 1-3 with lethal, so I can block something relevant on turn 2, and then I'll go into Lord Blightbark. Also, I really got to full art these things now. And full arting mythics are expensive. Yeah, we're going to block. Put it back. Hit a baby, Eddie. Get a goat. Yeah, sure. Gruesome Deed. Let's play Bunny. Culmination, Blightbush, well. Okay, we did hit a fourth resource. That's good. And if this can't be blocking something relevant, then I can Gruesome Deed it when they bring in like a Mommy Eddie or a Matriarch. RVS Janice with a new follow. Rivs Jins is what I'm going to call you. Thank you very much for the follow, mate. Hope you're enjoying yourself tonight. All right, so let's go with this. Matriarch of Flame or Boltwing Phoenix. Pick one. Boltwing Phoenix, you have selected. Means you are not playing Matriarchs. Alright. We will take two. Hero Fall will definitely be coming in out of the reserves for this match. Alright, so let's go ahead and I'm going to play Lord Blightbark, and then I'm going to just Gruesome Deed this Phoenix down. The next turn we have Groundskeeper. Not that we have any Deathcry effects right now, but... Oh, did I miss something? Oh, I forgot that that was a thing. That was silly. There's another resource. You can just play it again. Gross. Kind of forgot that was a thing, chat. And there's the cremate. That's all our opponent can do, though. That was actually a And Fireball. Alright. And a Scapa Goat. No fourth shard. That's good. Another well, not what we needed. Let's play the Groundskeeper. I really don't want to sack that Takahiro's ability, gonna be real honest. And a Cackler. Should have played Deed before Blightbark. Could have killed. Yeah, they could have. Okay. Not sure why they didn't activate Froththing's ability on the Baby Yeti here. But I'll take it. Oh, they're going to do it now. Because it's not basic. Okay. Yep, we'll take 4 and go to 6. There's the Escape Goat again. Well, that woke is not going to help me very much here. So 2-3. If they hit a shard, we're dead. If they hit a shard, we're dead. Actually, I think even if they don't hit a shard, we're dead. We'll see. I was holding a whole lot of 4 drops here. We're going to go to 2. If they have a burn spell, we're gone. Yep. Sure. Alright. You had it. Herofall comes in. Vampire Princess comes in. I feel like Withering Gaze comes in for Lasgar's Vengeance. Maybe not. I'll think about that for last. I think Paul comes in. I think Culmination just goes out here. Drokotar is too slow for this matchup. Anything else I just don't like? Everything else seems okay. Thoughts on Withering Gaze here? Gaze over the Culmination, sure. Let's bring in some Gazes. We'll take out... I can't take out Deadeye because of our restriction. Can trim Lackey a little bit. Trim Blightbark down to 1. I'll play 3 Gazes, and oh, we already have 2 Pauls. We can just play 2 Pauls then. Yeah, I think that's fine. We could even just play 1 Paul here and play the 4th Withering Gaze. But I think 3 here is good. I want it fairly early, but I don't need it immediately. Alrighty, let's give this a shot. It's good. We'll have a turn 2 Withering Gaze, as well as a turn 2 Naive Lackey. I accept. So what do y'all think of this Torque champion being used in burn decks as opposed to other things? Interested to hear your thoughts on that. Because I really think Angus is just the best champion for burn decks right now. But always open to hearing opinions. Bad cards. Nah, Scapegoat's good. Twenty-four life is greater than 17. Those are true facts. Blood Shard. Play the Well of Ancients. Let's Withering them first. Fireball, 3 shards, Righteous Outlaw, Yeti. I'll take their fireball, I guess. Should probably just be Angus. Might be better in the mirror, though. Yeah, lots of ruby on the ladder. It is a very, very good deck to climb the ladder with. I'll give it that. I'd be real mad if they just draw Asgard's Vengeance here. I'm just like, eh, whatever. We knew that was there. Emperor's Lackey. That's a good draw. Play Emperor's Lackey here out. I'm actually just going to go ahead and sack the Naive Lackey, because this is probably going to transform anyway, and it will just kill this on combat. So I'd rather get a card and some life out of it. Lord Blightbark is solid. That's also solid. Cool. Flip it. Flip it. Ooh, getting a Valor. Okay. Play the Valor, play the Goat. No Valor. Okay. And no attack? What? Well, they certainly don't have Lasgar's Vengeance. Wild Ice. I feel like I want Lord Blightbark here and then I can't play anything else. I'm just going to play the Ice. So we'll get Lord Blightbark. Then do I just Gruesome Deed something here? I feel like I just Gruesome Deed something. Or not. Like, I don't know. Baby Yeti. Play your Valor. There you go. Still no swing. Okay. Let's play Underworld Crusader first. So we can get two cards. Blood and Runeir. Alright, so we're just gonna... I'm Gruesome Deedy my Lackey. We're gonna take out the Righteous Outlaw. They could turn around and kill my Blightbark here, but... it's a risk. We're just gonna go and gaze them too. Two Ruby Shards. Alright, fairly safe. I would hold, their board isn't doing anything currently. Okay. If they have Matriarch, that would be lit. I'm just going to replay it. Probably Shard Goat something. Yeah. There we go. Another Lord Blightbark that we don't really need right now. So go ahead and get Runeir up in here. We'll sack the Blight Blossom. Another Withering Gaze. I'm not going to play it right now. I'll hold. Just gonna swing in with the Crusader. Actually, no, I'm not. In case they drew a fireball. Just in case they drew a fireball. We definitely have the upper hand here. I'm not too concerned. Yeah, they had a cremate. Alright. When they draw a shard, they're going to be real upset. Glad we didn't attack them. There's their goat. Rotpaw gang. It's pretty good. Pretty sure we just play groundskeeper here. We don't need to gaze. Yeah, and that's gonna spell the end for them. That's game two. Hooray. Alright, any changes here that you guys would do for game three being on the draw? Interested in hearing thoughts? I'm thinking about just clicking save. Current list is on the left. Feel free to take a look. Let me know. I have a few seconds here. Sorry about the little blip in internet connectivity there. Alright, hearing nothing. I think I'm just going to click save and go on. Blightbush, three shards, cottontail. Seems good for blockers at least. Yeah, I'm solid with this. Hit me with a goat. No goat. And it might as well be on the draw, opponent. And hero fall. Alright. Let's put a non-resource since we have Cottontail Explorer in our hand. Wouldn't be surprised if we just get Righteous Outlawed here. Cackler. Okay. Also fine. You should activate your ability. It's free. Withering Gaze. Let's get this on blood and play a bunny. Look at that. Doing things I like. I like everything in here. I'm pretty sure I just I'm just gonna actually pitch a shard. Still nothing. Alright, you did your job. Interesting. Actually, I should have done that. That's my fault. And then lily pad gets less value. Yep, that's my fault. You are right, Rivs. You are absolutely right. Fireball? No fireball. I should have also withering gaze there. God. Just not thinking straight. I apologize. My current face. We're going to take some damage here. But I'm also just going to hero fall it on the back. We're going to take 5 since we'd be taking 3 anyway. That is Shin Hair, isn't it? Yes, it is. Hell yes. Keep forgetting Rotpaw Gang is actually good. Where does Hero Falling at? Ooh! Ooh, baby! That was a thing that just happened. We're just gonna take their burning ire here. Oh, give it. I feel the vapors. I do declare, I feel the vapors. Mama. Yeah, I would concede too when that happened. That's that was a hell of a hero fall. That was a real good hero fall. Alright, folks, I'm going to take a quick break to get a cup of water and use the loo. I'll be back in just a minute. Going to put on some relevant music for you while I'm away, and I'll be right back. Don't go anywhere.
My sun, you were my earth. You didn't know all the ways I loved you. No, so you took a chance, made of a plan. But I bet you didn't think that they would come crashing down. No, you don't have to say what you did. Say that some things are better left unsaid. But it wasn't like you only talked to him, and you know it.
Don't act like you don't know it.
And all of these things people told me keep messing with my head. Should have picked honesty, then you may not have flown it.
Don't have to say
what you did.
I already know.
No chance,
you and me,
you'll never be,
and don't it make you sad about it?
Told me you love me, why did you leave me all alone?
All right, folks, we're back. Thank you for your patience there and for dealing with some Justin Timberlake vibes during a BRB. Looks like the GameForge forums don't exist anymore. Let's see, is there a new player guide? Let me go into Moobot and at least remove that while we find our next opponent. Thank you for pointing that out. I appreciate it. Commands, command list. There we go. Turn that one off. Thank you very much. You can point to... Sure, thank you. I will update the command with that. go back to Mubot. While we're finding an opponent here, folks, thanks for your patience. Of course, as soon as I say it, that happens. Playing against another ramp deck. There we go. Let's try this. I'm going to send the text command just to check. There we go. Thank you very much for that update, Fred. This is iffy, but I think I'm going to keep. Like, this might just be really bad. Yeah, I think we'll keep. We'll take a chance. We'll play Blood Ice on one. Get a resource. Alright, they played an ice of their own for the ramp deck. Another lily pad. Okay, that's value at least. I'm gonna go and get. I am gonna get a wild to be safe. We're just gonna, I believe we're just gonna open on Lackey here. We could have done Exarch. I don't think either really matters here since they're just ramping. You're killing me, Fred. Killing me. Righteous Outlaw. All right. All right, let's try that. It has been updated to your second link. Well, Naive Lackey's going to do its job. But I'm a nice guy, sure. That's what they all say. All people say that. Another lily pad. God bless. Just start with Runeir Hierophant then. Oh, that was actually really dumb. Let's kill it. Alright, fine. Yeah, they're gonna transform it, aren't they? Whoops! That was a dumb play on my part. Life happens. Oh, they're just gonna play their own Runeir, which is better than our Runeir. It's fine, the Blossom can trade. Yeah, fair. Good old Death Cries. It's a bunny. Let's bunny up. Hit two shards. I feel better about what I'm about to do. Let's sack you. We just have Gladiator and Crush. Alright, so we're gonna sack the Cottontail. Well, something gain some life. I'll just play Exarch out to block, since it's lethal. It would be nice if they just hit a spider right there. Yep, gonna give it Crush. Surging Wildfire. Yep. Yep. 4-8. feel like I had to do that, really. Light bush! Hot, 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 hot. Make a battle hopper to block. It's light bush and underworld. And we have woke probably in 2 turns. Do another surging wildfire, because that would just be rude. Communion of wax. A Crocosaur, of course. Well, that's disgusting. All right. Light bush is good, at least. Now I can just play woke. So don't we just get this for real cheap? Equal to that card's cost. Yeah. So we can just do this and then play woke for free. Move. Okay. Dreamweaver Ancient. Still not all that concerned. Yeah, you're gonna force me to block, but I'm not too worried about it. Just with the 8-9. Interesting that they're blocking with the 8-9. They probably have a blitz. Gonna double block with the Blight Blossoms here. Yep. Blightbark Paladin. Sack one of these. Deadeye. Alright. It's pretty hot. It's gonna. I think we're just gonna stick to that. This is probably not the right way to do this, but going back to 20 is pretty good. Sure. Sure. It's Knock out their summon troop and we win. Like, we just win. Yeah, we just win. Alright. We stayed woke and we won. So, pointers for all you kids, stay woke. Gemworn Prowler's fine. It's probably all that I really need to bring in here. Maybe the other Paul. Let me take out our two combinations. One Naive Lackey and Fentio seems... Fentio or Exarch either seems eh. I'm gonna take out Fentio. Three shards, good curve, let's go. Blood shard would be great. Lily pad. Alright, we'll play the blood ice. Put our logos where they're supposed to be. Paul. Okay. I'm gonna play Blightbush now and then probably Deadeye and Lackey next turn. I think that'll just help our Paul later on if needed. Pyre Strike. That voids it. Good Pyre Strike. Alright, that was good. That was real good. Let's go Blood, Ruininger. Next turn we just go Lackey Deadeye. Who messaged me? Heart of Embers. Okay. Stay woke. Get a Battle Hopper in here. I think we're just gonna Underworld a Naive Lackey. Not gonna attack because I wanna have a decent blocker. So yeah, we attack. I have a decent blocker. Let's gain some life. Well, okay. Yep, probably gonna hit my Naive Lackey. Thanks for the card. I'm just taking... See, the problem is if I don't block here... If I block here, I can just kill it. Yeah, not attacking. Probably smart. Blood shard. Requires a scrounge 3, right? Let's get our Legion of Trump blockers. I'm gonna swing. See if you have a blitz on defense. No blitz. I have a good sack outlet here. Another Heart of Embers with double damage. Well, that'll be gross. I need to know which one this trigger is hitting. They're both hitting this, so I'm just gonna sack this anyway. Alright. Seems like an interesting play on their part. I mean, I do just have Emperor's Lackey. Light Bush. This is. I'm just living the life right now, right? Let's do wild so we can actually play our Woken Drokhtar next turn. Blightbush. Paul. And Concession. Awesome. Alright, so this deck's sweet. I really like it. We're back into the top 200. That doesn't mean a whole lot, but hooray! Alright, let's get another opponent. Play it this turn by sacking Bush. Could've. You are right. They had conceded at that point, though. Two more troops hit with power one. That brings it to zero. That is fair. All right, folks. Well, our Find the Net next opponent. Do want to say thank you to our sponsor, BattleShopper.com. If you're looking for those last few cards for your hex deck, feel free to check them out and use my promo code Yana5 and get yourself 5% off your next order. So I do want to thank everybody for tuning in tonight. We're playing for at least another 30 minutes, maybe a little longer than that. And we'll go on from there. So again, check out the site. Next time you buy cards, use that code, get yourself a bit of a discount. All right, looks like we are in game. We have a good hand if we get a shard. I'm going to keep it. Like, we might just get destroyed. But we'll see. There's a shard. Hooray. Just playing out a rust bucket for the sake of it. Alright. I accept. It's a bunny. Right on cue, little fluffers. Whiff. Kara, did you say something? No? Okay. Bunny whiffed. That's unfortunate. Three really good things against this deck, too. Gonna hit an Underworld Crusader. That does give us a turn four Paul, like straight up. Get up Light Bush, alright. Ground Creeper. They do have a Shin Hair. I probably want this. Actually want it on double wild, just because we have Woken in hand. Let's play out a Runeir. I know that means I can't activate my champ ability, but I really don't want to sack anything right now. I'm hoping we find another shard at some point. Yep, I'm just going to take four. cremate. Death Seeker. Okay. One scrounge Death Seeker coming up. And a Rust Bucket. Surprised I didn't play that pre-combat, but sure. Blood Ice. Just what I needed. Alright, so I'm pretty sure I just play Runeer here. We're just gonna sack this. There we go. Yeah, having you talk a hero power helps you get the shard number 4. Alright. You got me. Deathcry is great against this deck for what it's worth. Miss 3 damage by not attacking with the... Sure. Yeah, you're right, Hodor. I appreciate the feedback for sure. That's... And I mean that. I know I pretty much just fed them some cards, but... Lord Blightbark. I think that changes my plan a little bit. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Because now we have blockers. If I get hit by another Laz card, I'm going to feel real bad. Remating my face? What do you got? What? Lazgars? Are you kidding me? Alright. 3-4 put me to 1? Sure. Stay woke. Like, I'm dead to several things, but I'm also just alive to many things. Got it. Wild Shard. I want to keep 2 troops up just in case they have a speed troop. That is very possible with this deck. Yep. Lightbush seems at bueno. force him to block. Yep. And I believe I am just going to sack this to get out of harm's way, just in case. Play Underworld Crusader. Target treatment control the Death Cry. Oh, yes. Yes, please. Let's make some more 7/7s. Or 6/6s, sure. Hooray! We did it. Yeah, you and I are on the same page there, Hodor. Alright. Hero Fall seems great. Withering Day seems great. Prowler seems fine. Culmination is bad here. We can trim one Paul. We can trim one Lackey. I'm going to cut Finteo. Cut one Paladin and... pretty sure Woke is just real good. I think we either trim one Gruesome Deed or one Underworld Crusader. What do we think, chat? Yeah. Okay, fine, because I'm playing two. This deck really has a lot of play. I like it. Alright, so two good shards, two Emperor's Lackey. We have play here. I'm keeping this. That's fair. So you would have cut both Wokens then? Anything you can do, I can do a turn slower. Alright, cool. Good to know. President, not to sack that to the lackey. Guess I just wanted my Emperor's Lackey to die. It's fair. Alright. We are going to Withering Gaze them. Plantsmith, Apprentice, Prowler. Alright, so they have a Prowler. Good to know. But we did with. They have three troops, so they can get full value out of their blam. So let's just, let's put out lackey number two. The next turn we can start doing some Takahiro things. That was my phone. Glad it didn't crack. All right. Just hit the Blamsmith you know you want, because then you'll get a Blamsack. I would play Blamsmith if I were in your position. Culmination over Gaze in this matchup. Okay. Oh, it is all crypts, isn't it? That's fair. Scrounge make Dreddos. Alright. I'll take this trade. Sack of Dreddling. Yep. Only get hit for two now. The Rogue Crusader. I totally saw this and thought Shinhair, but whoops. Alright, so we're going to play Blightbark Paladin, I believe. And I'm just going to do nothing with it right now, because I have a good blocker. It's fine. I could Gruesome Deed the Dread Apprentice here, but I'm more concerned about hitting the Blamsmith. I don't want to play Underworld Crusader because I know they have Gemborn Paladin. Yeah, we're going to block. I don't want to, but we're going to. Hey, Riley, down. Just playing a Pyresmoke Cabalist. Okay. There's the Blamsmith. Yep. So you got a Blamsack. Runeer was a good draw. It's hard. It's hard to know what to do here. We knew that was coming. And we're dead. They had everything. Game 3. Culmination over Gaze. Let's go with that. Should have sacked Runeer. Yeah, probably. I think we live like another turn at that point. You're right. You know, it's going to feel good. Whenever I decide to start playing this deck correctly, it's going to feel great. Like, I'm already above 50% with this deck, just playing it because the deck's powerful. But, like, give it some time, get some reps. Like, I'm excited for this. This will be fun. Everybody's having a fantastic evening. For those of you who are here for the first time, my name's Professor Yana, also known as Tom. Feel free to give that follow button a click on top of the stream. Would love to have you come back for future streams. I play Hex twice a week. It's normally Tuesday, Wednesday nights. This week it's Monday, Wednesday. But yeah, give that follow button a click. I would definitely appreciate the support. You want to get that next level of support and subscribe. You don't have to. I would love if you did. $4.99 a month or that Twitch Prime sub. And I have a new sub perk that I'm starting this month that is retroactive to my current subscribers as well. Submit a deck list to me. Shoot me a message on Twitter at profyana_Twitch. You can shoot me a message on here, really anything. Just give me a 60-card hex deck, constructed standard. And at the end of the month, I'm going to take a look at all of the... 2 at max. Whoops. little late, sorry. But yeah, I'm gonna take a look at all the deck lists, pick the one I like. I would definitely like homebrews because I like trying cool things out on stream. And the winner will get a free primal pack at the end of the month. And the next stream, I will be playing their deck exclusively for one stream and making tweaks to it. So if you're interested in being part of that and joining up the High Council, would encourage you to subscribe. Speaking of bad hands, this hand's better. Okay. Easy there, cat. I don't want you eating bad things. Watch out. Yeah, you shouldn't be getting into that, cat. Hey, look, a shard. They probably either have Deathseeker or Underworld Crusader. Gravengeist. Okay. Runeer Hierophant. I'm just going to play this on Blood. They have a Gemborn Prowler, they have it. They play more than me. Next turn we'll Blightbush and the Naive Lackey. See, even without the Lord Blightbarks, this deck just feels good. It's a nice, solid mid-range deck. A lot of play to the creature base. A little more difficult to play, but more rewarding when you get it right. Swing for one. Yep, they had one. Sack. There's a combination. Let's play Blightbush and Lackey. Gonna stack the Lackey now. Hit Lord Blightbark. Hit Hero Fall. Mmm. That felt good. Here comes an Underworld Crusader. It's gonna get Hero Falled. Matriarch. Just the one at Matriarch. Okay. They want a Dreadling. It's fair. I just block that every time. I should have sacked at the Lackey afterwards. That was my bad. I missed a sack. Could have made this a 4-4. Is it worth it to just sack everything out here and make them discard their hand? I mean, that's the question right now. Do I sack these four troops and then culminate? They're just going to be chump blockers anyway. I'm going to try it. This seems fun. Attack. Oh god, it's my t- Oh my god, that was so bad. Pum 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 pond. Pum 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 pond. You are so right and I am so bad. Ooh, mama. Well, we did it now. What did we hit? Deed, Prowler, Vengeance. Yep. Jeez. Well, I feel like a silly, silly goose now. Thanks, Rivjins. Oh my god. Why didn't I think of that? I am just bad. Of course you hit a scrounged Underworld Crusader. It's a good thing I have Hero Fall. I feel like I'm just taking 6 here. Yeah, let's go to 10. They don't have anything in hand. Gemborn Prowler this. And I'm gonna Hero Fall the Graven Geist. Actually, I can't yet. Fine. Maybe that wasn't the right thing to do. I'm not sure. Must be nice. Yep. I don't have anything in hand, so. It's an Exarch. Let's hold. Double block, only one. I don't. Fine. A Hero Fall before they get to tap, just in case that's a Lasgar's in their hand. Only one Graven Geist. Alright. Only one Graven Geist. That was sad. Let me guess, you're gonna get a Scrounged Rust Bucket? Spawn. Okay. Dude, I'm not blocking, you're insane. I'll take 2 extra cards. Yep. Happily take 2 extra cards and have you hellbent. Gruesome Deed and Rotpaw Gang. Put out the Groundskeeper. Primordial Sabertooth. Fine. Good draw, opponent. Good draw. Lily pad. I don't think I have a shit. Yep, I do. Got the Rotpaw Gang. It's not basic, right? Alright, and we got the concession. I punted a lot in that match. Thank you for catching him, chat. I appreciate it. All right, I think we will play one more match to end the night. I do want to thank everybody once again for tuning in this evening. I know there's a lot you could be doing. After this match, I'm going to send you over to Jeff, who is playing Magic right now, if he's still playing anyway. But yeah, definitely thank you for the constructive criticism there, folks, mainly from Hodor and Rivgens. It is appreciated. I like getting better. And with a new deck, I'm prone to make mistakes, so thanks for calling them out. Have in my inventory stash nowadays. Do I have boosters? Yeah, I have boosters. I have 7 Frostheart booster packs, apparently. Okay. Hey, Rivgens, Hodor. Shoot me your in-game names. I think I already know yours, Hodor. It's just your name with an extra O. I'm gonna give you each a booster pack for helping me out tonight. Definitely appreciate it. But a small thing to give for you helping me out. Sevier. Sevier, yep. Give you a pack. Enjoy your Frostheart pack. Thank you guys. Much appreciated. I would not get better at this game without the help of friends, so you all are great. We have our last opponent for the night. What do we got? Captain Jack? But where's the rum gone? What even is this champion? Oh, Swamp Butt. Oh no, we're gonna get Swamp Butted, guys. This might just be a burn deck. Alright, let's have some fun. Alright, this hand's good. We'll keep it. Having relevant blockers against a burn deck here is good with Blight Bushes. We get one shard, we're in Underworld territory. Yeah, I think we're okay here. Let's keep. Goat. Yep, this is just going to be a mono Ruby deck with a different champ. Take one. We'll be at 15 before we can do anything relevant. Baby Eddie with the wrong art. We'll take 3. We'll go to 14, and then we're going to Blight Bush. Yeah, I think somebody in Jeff's chat was talking about this today. Stay woke. As in, absolutely not what we need right now. Let's just Blight Bush. Trades with the Bolt Spasm. Alright, you get a Swamp Gas. Okay. Just gonna block the Bolt Spasm here. So I'm taking 3 either way. All right, good Lasgars. stuck on shards here. Baby Yeti or Mama Yeti, kill me. Mama Yeti, kill me. If I block Mama Yeti, I take 5 and go to 1. Oh, that has Crush. Yeah, I'm just dead. All right. Next game. We just didn't get a shard. So let's bring in our real spells. 2. I kind of like Withering Gaze more in this matchup because Lasgar just wrecks me. They play things too quickly for Combination to be that good. Like Vampire Princess is probably okay. We can take out Fenteo. We can bring in, bring in Withering Gaze in this matchup. Don't know if we need all 4. We definitely need some number of them. Light Bark. Hit Lackey. And then hit Woke. And I need a troop. Alright, so that means we're gonna probably play. We'll play Fenteo, and I'll cut 1 Withering Gaze. Thought we had enough. Yeah. I had 2 Blight Barks. Oh well. I should have turned a Blight Bark, you're right. Just wasn't thinking. This is slow. Good, but slow. Alright, let's go with it. Could have actually seeked fortune there. Yeah, I saw that after I clicked save, Rivgens. I thought I had taken one out already. I didn't want to hit troop threshold for Underworld. Right. The cat's like climbing on me almost to get food. I normally have fed them an hour ago. Hero Fall. Isn't that just a nice spell? Baby Yeti again. I don't want a Hero Fall, a scapegoat, like, that just seems wrong. But I also feel that I'm just gonna get, Lasgard out of this game otherwise. Alright. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Show me the Lasgards next turn, I guess. Could lay Opera there to stem the bleeding from Goat? Could. I think playing Runeer is better right now, though, because I can play the Lily next turn and get an extra ability hit off the Runeer. That is going to get Hero Fall next turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now it's on 2. Lock this and go to 10. I'm gonna Hero Fall the Matriarch. Make a Battle Hopper. Hero Fall Matriarch of Flames. Only 2. Alright. I'm Wait till next turn to sack things. Because we have Deadeye. Oh, hit me with the Lasgars for 4. Fa-fang. Imagine just replay the goat. Yep. Wall of Ancients. That seems good. Yeah, I took the Wokens out. Let's go ahead and play Deadeye. We'll play Underworld. Sack Deadeye here. This minus one, minus one. I want to keep these up to block. We hit a Fenteo and gain 3. Alright. Next turn, we'll Blightbark. Oh no, we have 3. We can scrounge a, No, I don't have 3 troops. Terp. Can hit Blightbark for a lethal troop. They do not have a Lasgars. That's what that just told me. Do have a Blight Bush, though. So let's play Blight Bush and Blightbark Paladin. Just blight all the things. Now I have enough things that this doesn't matter as much. Just one block. Take 7. Alright, it's gonna... Okay, fine. That's a thing you can do. It's fair. Alright. Just get him back. Why not? Sun Soul Phoenix.
Hello.
Hello. Baby Heil. BB Hill. I think that's how it is with the new follow. Thank you very much, mate. I appreciate it. Withering Gaze. We'll gaze first. And we're going to paw and kill this Sun Soul. Doesn't seem too thrilled about this. A Fentankler Ruby Shard. Alright. We're going to destroy target opposing card. Sun Soul Phoenix. They have exactly 0 actions in their deck. Hit you with an 8. Alright. Ruby Shard Cackler. Blood Shard. Two Blight Blossoms. Swing, swing, swing. Come on, opponent. I've got killing to do. We're only going to tap this one to give this plus three and trade them up. That's fine. Yep. Still trade them. I'm okay with that. You have one turn. You have zero turns. All right. So I feel like our hand's just good now. Like the only, I mean, on the draw, I feel like I just have to keep in Withering Gazes. So I feel like we're just good here. I'm just going to save, and we're going to hope that we win game three on the draw. Folks, it's going to be my last game of the evening. I do want to say thank you once again to everybody who tuned in tonight. I encourage you to follow if you haven't followed the stream already. I'll be back online on Wednesday night at 7:30 Pacific. And I would encourage y'all to tune back in. We might run this deck back. I might play something else. Haven't decided yet. No turn one play. That feels real good for us. Please tell me you just click through your attack phase. Nom, 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 nom. Play your escape goat. Come on, do it. Do it. No? Okay. Another Well of Ancients. So we have perfect resources now. Let's see, what's in our hand? You can play everything. Let's do it on resource. We'll draw enough in the meantime. Righteous. Righteous. I'm gonna play Exarch this turn now. I have a reasonable blocker here. Or we, well, if I play Lord Blightbark, it just dies to the Scarlet Swordsman that they'll inevitably play. So yeah, Exarch. Next turn, I'll Lord Blightbark and Lackey, depending on what they do. Still choosing it. Okay. Just have a cremate or something. Gonna block. Yep. Intrigued. And a fireball. Okay. So go to 12. It's fine. That's a one-shot effect, so. Lord Blightbark. Naive Lackey. Into Sack the Lackey. Alright. It's not bad. Not bad, not bad. We have a Withering Gaze. That'll make for a good next turn. Yeah, I'm not sure why he didn't Valor either, but like, he fireballed, so he 2-for-1'd. Like, I'll take that. Fine. Fireball it. Swing for 4. Swing for 5. Blightbark Paladin here in Gruesome Deed.
Hello!
Hello! Walazin56 with a new follow. Appreciated. Hope you're enjoying yourself tonight. Let's knock out both of them. Might not have been the right thing to do, but it clears our board for a turn and they only have three cards. And then we can just Withering Gaze them next turn into Wurunir. Whoa, that's not what I wanted. Somebody typed in chat. Paladin indeed looks good, yeah. Matriarch, Shard. Me for three. For a second, we're just playing Underworld Crusader next turn. Let's Withering Gaze. What do you got? What do you know about me? Mama Yeti, Crackling Magma, Sabertooth. Well, Yeti would be a bad time for us. Sabertooth is fine, though. Absolutely playing Crusader, though, so we have a block against Yeti. Next turn, I'll play Runeer and Crusader. Oh, they just Sabertooth this, put me to... I might just die from that. Sabertooth to 5, put me to 5. They could put me to 2 if they hit a shard. Yep. Runeer Blightbush. Sure. Did you draw a fireball? Be a little tilted if you drew a fireball, wouldn't lie. Okay, we're at 2. Keep drawing shards. Yep, should've. But we're going to Runeer into Blightbush. Hey, do you just have a fireball? Come on. Allow it to resolve. Sack Blight to hero. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. Go back to 5. Fireball me in response. I'll just feel... But come on, man. Yep, let's ruin your trade with Mama. Folks, if you're playing Hex and you see yourself at a low life total, don't consider it a game lost. Your life is a resource, not a crutch. Until you're at 0, you've not lost. Always remember that. A little afraid of playing this just in case they have like a burn spell of some sort. We go to 3 and then could die, but no, we're just gonna play it out. Some swamp gas. No swing? Nah, alright. Hit the Emperor's lackey. Alright. I feel like I just swing with this now. I swing with Underworld now, correct? I'm gonna leave the rune ear up for Mama Yeti. Alright. Next turn, I'm probably just gonna sack the 4/4 rune ear. There's Mama Yeti. You can swing. I think you would. I love this card. Just want to let it be known that I really like this card. I should have killed Matriarch in case they have burned to the ground. They get another shard. That was just bad of us. Womp womp. Just get up to 8 to be safe. Another well, fine. No, I don't want to concede. I'm going to keep these up to be safe. I feel like they have more 4 drops if they weren't playing anything. Swamp gas. Alright, you can get that. Oh dear. Here comes the burn to the ground. This is why I should have hit the Matriarch and not the Mama Yeti. That was an idiotic play on my part. So, sorry. They didn't attack? Hooray? Okay. Gonna let that be. I can't dead on crackback. Fair. Nice little game of stalemate right now is what you're saying. More swamp gas. Wow, I'm bad. Did that early. Thank you for not attacking. Yeah, I'm going to start now. I wanted to get rid of the Matriarch first. You and I are on the same page. Realize I have to attack. Thank you. Kaka. Kaka. Good thing this has. Yeah. I can block that. GG's opponent. Alright folks, well that is going to end the night for me. I'm going to send you all over to Jeff, who's playing some Magic, and I would encourage you to check out his stream. He is definitely a great Magic player, great Hex player. But for me, I'm going to call it a night. I will see you all in 2 days on Wednesday night at 7:30. Thank you to everybody who followed tonight, definitely appreciate it. And I will let you all go. Have a great night, and thanks for watching. See you Wednesday.